minimal amount of. Now,
are we just going to call it and say Proud Mary and Happy Trails? Is that it?
Well, that, I mean,
was Proud Mary the one we did the other day?
Yeah.
A couple weeks back?
I thought it was California Raining or whatever that song was.
Well, we did that
California Dreaming?
You're thinking of It Never Rains in Southern California.
That's the one.
That wasn't the Creedence song.
I know, but after you guys sang it, you were like, oh, this would be great for open mic.
I think Proud Mary's better, myself.
Well, it's one everybody knows.
It's not one that the Austin Ukulele Society has done.
Proud Mary.
Right.
I mean, Walter knows things like that to steer us clear of certain songs. Is Proud Mary something the Austin Ukulele Society's done?
We've sung it in meetings, but we...
But you haven't performed.
We haven't performed it.
Okay.
Just so we could get the Joe Bonham.
I think that's a good call.
Okay, well, those two songs. So we got to... We got to do those tonight.
I agree. You want to do those first or last or
somewhere else? Well, we can do Proud Mary first and then Happy Trails last.
That sounds like a good plan.
Are we going to do Crazy?
What about this song that's already up?
Bonnie's going to do
that. Bonnie's song.
Get that done before we start.
Well, Bonnie, do you want to do Crazy? Are you?
The small ukulele group I play with on the Sunshine Coast here, they always end their get-togethers with Happy Trails.
That's what we're doing.
Yeah.
That's what we've been doing since we started meeting.
Lots of people
do that. We end with, what's that song?
Aloha? Aloha?
No, like, Fly Away. I'm going to fly away, that one.
Oh.
You know which one I'm talking about?
Some bright morning when this
yeah,
life is over.
I'll fly away, yeah. I think it started in a church, so.
Definitely a gospel tune.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So can you see your music, Bonnie?
I can.
Okay.
Is it good for you guys?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, before you mute yourself, so the is each one of these lines called a bar, whatever that is? There are four visible right now.
Major.
And I'm going to sing all four and then two more if you scroll down. Worry, wondering. And then after the G7, I'm going to repeat. And then I'm going to end with the last two.
Okay, so after What in the World Did I Do, you're going to go back to the beginning?
Go back up. Very top, yeah.
Okay.
And I guess everyone can look at the notes. C sharp dim is
diminished.
Yeah, diminished.
It's pretty easy. As soon as you can read, I couldn't even read it at first, and then I realized.
Okay, we're going to mute, and you can
okay.
Take it away.
Thank you. Crazy. Why do I let crazy for feeling so lonely.
Real nice.
Very good. That was great.
Yeah. Messed up some of the measures, but
real nice.
That's not an easy song.
I agree. I think that's underrated for complexity. Yeah. I think it's harder than it sounds.
This is one of the easier versions.
Yeah.
I've seen it. I've seen a bunch of worse versions.
Yeah, I've got fewer chord changes than other ones.
It's a good for an alto voice too. It's a lot of low notes and not too many high notes.
Yeah, I mean, in C, it's not too bad.
Okay, Proud Mary then?
All right.
Proud Mary, let's
see. Okay. So
we should spell John Fogerty's name correctly.
This isn't the same key that Kevin gave it to us in. Somebody chose.
Well, this
is
like a different version to me.
Well, this is the one that I got.
It's the one we played
last week.
Yeah, yeah, I remember. I remember thinking then, boy, that's a different key. I mean, not that the chords are hard. I have a great
friend. How y'all doing?
Well, this is
good. Hi, Brenda.
Close to
yo.
John Fogerty's.
This is a song they're thinking of doing for the open mic.
Yeah.
I got it.
It's just
yep.
Like the version I had, except it's in a different key.
Oh, okay.
That's the only issue.
It's one of the few songs that somebody else did it better than the original artist. I really like Tina Turner's version of it.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to do that version. Only Tina
we
Turner
did
can do
out
that.
Front dance.
Yeah.
She did a real good version of it.
Okay, all right. Everybody, you ready? We can talk. Okay, I'll count it in. One, two, three, four.
Thank you.
the intro drumming thing, or the, you know, that just the thing we did at the end. I lose count on the F and the D,
well, you know,
the, or the strum pattern or something.
The, the problem is there's more strums than beats. And so there's, you know, it's like four, it's a whole measure on F, but it's
so. And well, what about at the top? What happens with the D's after the F? But it's like a something like that.
Well, they, you know, I was gonna try. I was thinking about working on it because they're doing.
Well, that's what I'm inclined to do on the D's. Is...
And then, yeah, rather than just. It's got to have that.
Yeah, I like that better.
So, I don't, you know, it's like on the, there are two beats on the C when you start. It's.
Sounds like C C A A A C C A. That's what it's sounding like. Three on the C.
If it was written out, those it wouldn't all be quarter notes, you know, eighth notes or whatever. It's more, those slashes are to more represent the count of the measure. So like the C and the A are in one measure. So it's.
Still doing the D thing wrong. Let me play what I'm doing.
Okay.
You can maybe correct me. Wait.
Well, to me, everything sounded the same except the first part of the D.
Yeah, that's exactly what I think I'm doing differently than you, but I haven't figured out yet what I'm supposed to do.
But you know, it's like when there's something that John Fogerty does there that's a little different than what I'm doing. Because, you know, I mean. That's a different. It needs to be that.
You do something a little different, I'm not quite sure what, and then you get into this.
I think what I was doing was something different for the intro, and then when we started on the...
Yeah, it's
one thing when just one person's doing it.
But
it's, and what about this idea? Gary, if you feel comfortable, can you record those strums at the beginning and then an outro strum, and that way we can all look at it and try to get it down in our privacy of our own homes?
Sure. Yeah. I think that'd be fantastic. And then also the other thing we can do is just, you can just play it by yourself.
Well, that would be fine. I mean, that's fine.
Okay. I would like to try to learn it and match what you're doing. So if you don't mind making a video, that'd be fine.
No, that would be great. It would be good to have, you know, at least two of us doing it and doing it in
the same thing.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. All right.
Now, Tug has a YouTube channel. Can we get into that and record it for that?
Sure.
Upload it to that?
Yeah, if you can make yourself a video and send it to me, I'll put it up there just like that.
Okay, on the website?
On the YouTube thing.
Okay.
Yeah, don't name it Proud Mary, just strumming practice.
Yeah.
So we don't get canceled.
Yeah, I don't know. When I was looking at this song, because Paulette and I played this a while back, and then I brought it back last week, and then I was looking at some different videos, and there's other people on there doing their own versions of this song, so I don't think John Fogerty is.
All right, good.
What's his face? And
oh, right, yeah, Don, not terrible with Don, the copyrights.
Yeah.
You're not doing an Eagles song.
Yeah, right. So do you want to run through it one more time, and then...
Sounds good to me.
Okay, I'll probably play it differently this time, so. Okay. One, two, three, four.
Rolling.
Does anybody think it would sound a little bit better if we dropped out one of those Rolling on the Rivers at the end?
Four, that's kind of long for me as well.
You want to do three?
I would rather do three.
Okay.
Three sound, I mean, it's getting too much of a good thing, you know?
Yeah.
Well, you know, yeah, because what, you know, what they're doing is somebody's, you know, kind of yelling over top of it, you know, rolling.
Yeah.
You know, doing something different. And
well, we can work on something different if you want, but the way it is, it just sounds like it's going a little too long to me.
Well, I kind of agree.
Every time I wanted to stop and move on into it.
It sounds like we're in agreement then.
Okay.
Unless we can change it to be more interesting on the subsequent iterations than just delete one. Let me see.
And isn't three like the golden number for endings?
Oh, that sounds familiar. I think you might be right.
That sounds good to me.
That's the only reason why I brought it up.
There you go. I will change the key, though. Why did you do that?
It sounds better already.
You don't want to do it in E, though.
Yeah, let's do it in E.
Oh, boy.
It must revert to its original key when you change something.
I guess. Although I've changed things before and it didn't do that. I don't know.
Interesting.
This is a weird program and it's...
That doesn't sound right.
I can't even get back to the... See, there we are.
I didn't put it in D. No.
I think D is the one.
I don't know what happened.
No, you got to go up.
Yeah.
It was the second choice. I think
you got to go up two half steps.
But the... Oh, you're right. Okay, so that's B flat, so C flat, E, C, right?
C.
Yeah. Oh, now it's right.
There you go.
Hey, look at that. You're back where you started.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see if we get stuck with three. Yeah. Okay, so there we are. All right, we're done with that one now. So, Ray Jen, do you want to? Oh, yeah.
If I'm going to practice.
That one in Happy Trails, we probably should send out PDF.
Separate of it.
Yeah.
All right, I'll do that.
Yeah. Well, okay. I've got the one Happy Trails I had from when we had all these songs that we were going to do, and then the whole thing got canceled. I had them all put in this book. And,
Happy
Trails was the last one. And it was just exactly what you sang every time. So
great.
I always have this one I can pull up.
Well, I'll still send out a separate email with the PDF of Happy Trails and Proud Mary.
Do the.
So, you might.
Other people don't do that.
do you want to do one of yours?
Yeah, I'll do
one.
The one on the screen right now is fine.
Mexican Home. There it is.
Who sent my Mexican Home in?
Okay.
What did he ask?
Who sent it in? It's Mary Jane.
Okay. That's a great song.
Yeah, this is just.
Yeah, I think I heard it here before. It's a great song.
I did it once.
Was it you? Yeah, it was great.
This is not a new song for me, but it's so hot. Actually, it was a year ago, and it was not quite this hot, but it was still in July, and we were having some pretty hot weather. It's a great song for when you're just dying of the heat. So I guess we're ready. It got so hot last night, I swear you could hardly breathe. Heat lightning burned the sky like alcohol. I said,
Great.
Good.
I like that line about the headlights running across the room, you know, the kitchen.
Yeah, yeah. I like the one
just
about the
visualize that.
The boo-boo clock dying of shock.
Yeah.
What were you going to say, Paul, I think?
I like that the windows feel no pain.
Yeah. Yeah.
Song on the Yellow Submarine cartoon soundtrack.
Yeah.
And so here we go. Yeah, this came out, I think, what was it, 68 or something like that?
Yeah. And I guess it didn't keep on running in reruns like Charlie Brown, because
well,
I never saw it later.
It's been played. Things have been done with it.
There was some Beatles movie on last night.
You've heard of the
Blue
Meanies, haven't you?
I don't think
you?
It was Yellow Submarine.
Oh.
Sorry.
I was just trying to think of something that a younger person would have.
Yeah. It doesn't ring a bell. But I just miss some things, living in a small town without a lot of community stations and stuff, you know?
Yeah. What small town did you live in?
Mineola, like up in East
Texas.
Oh,
yeah, I know where that is. Yeah. It's even a stop on the Texas Eagle train line. Because it's east of Dallas, right?
About 90 miles east of Dallas. And there is a railroad track that runs right through town.
Yeah.
And it was originally a train town, is how it got established.
Yeah.
I don't know really any more than that. Like, why did they build a train stop there? I could see building a train track through there because you want to get from there to there, but I don't know why they stopped in
Mineola. Back in the days of shipping corn and alfalfa.
I suppose there were farmers in the area, that's true.
That's really what the train stops were mostly used them for.
Okay.
Was to ship stuff.
Well, they had to have one every 30 miles for the tank
get
water and fuel.
Water.
I don't know how old their railroad track is.
It goes back to the 1800s.
Oh wow!
Yeah.
I had no idea.
Yeah.
Well, maybe we ought to get a Zoom person to do the song.
Hey, Martin.
The big wave of track building was in the late 1800s in Texas.
Yeah. So you have a song, Marty?
Nope, I don't. Hey, while I've got your attention, Paul, disregard my email relating to Git.
I disregard about half your emails.
don't spend any energy on it.
All right.
Cool. I figured it out.
Yeah, I saw that you followed up and said you figured it out.
Oh, okay. I didn't know you knew that.
Yeah.
All right.
So Brandon,
Paul and I are working on a new website for Tug to be unveiled at some future date when we've done a few more tests.
It's looking good.
Yeah, a few people have seen it. And one of the big things is Paul has come up with a way of listing all the songs in alphabetical order, and so you can find them much quicker now.
Yeah, that's great.
Wow, that would be awesome.
Great resource.
Well, you will be one of the test subjects to see whether you can print them out or not.
Yes.
That's the intention.
Yeah. Well, sometimes I can print things out, but I can't save them to Word.
Well, these will be PDFs.
Yeah, that last one.
That ought to be a lot easier, actually.
Word could work with it, and it looked like it was saved.
Right.
I pressed the save button several times.
Yeah.
And then when I went to look for it, it was nowhere to be found.
Yep.
And it must have just because of the type of file that it started out from, you know, it couldn't handle it.
Well, anyway, it turned out okay. Yeah, that's a frustrating experience for sure.
But I did get a printout, and you know, sometimes that's all you need. Just,
you know, the one thing about that new website, it really does need a piece of art.
Art? There's like a big banner with you.
Yeah, well, the banner has been around for like 50 years or something.
Oh, new art.
A new banner.
Okay. I think we've got a person who's signing up to do some new art for us.
Yeah. Well, it would be good to plop pieces of art here and there rather than just have one piece of art and that's it.
All art is accepted for review.
It's time to get back to music.
Errol, you want to do your song? Did you get that PDF? I emailed.
Errol, you're muted.
So, did you get the one I sent you?
I forwarded it on to Gary, and he's pulling it up as we speak.
Okay, let me do this. Open attachment with
Live
Song.
I've been working on the River Blues for months, and every time I get close to doing it, somebody does it out from under me. And then I wait several months, and then somebody else does.
Well, stop doing that. Just play it whenever you're ready.
Is this one of your songs, Mary Jane?
Well, it's a song, I don't do this exact version, but I think it's a similar, it's probably going to sound similar.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to usurp your song.
No, I wasn't going to do it tonight, but I'm going to do it for another group, and I have the same problem with the other group, too.
So I'll play the instrumental, and if someone who wants to play the kazoo can do it, I'm just going to play, if that's okay.
Yeah, please do.
I'm ready to go. You can hear me okay?
Hey, yes. Sounds great.
And I'll just do my own little intro, if that's okay.
To D sharp minor, A to D.
Yeah, it's sort of a nice change in the sequence.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
What's the D sharp minor 5? Is that 5? Is that a B flat or something?
That's
the 5 in there.
It's a D sharp. It's a
D sharp. Okay. But the dash 5 is what I'm talking about.
Sorry?
I understand D sharp minor. Yeah. Part I'm having trouble with is the dash 5. Does that mean you get the fifth note in the D sharp scale?
I think it's the flat 5 of the D sharp.
A flat 5, yeah.
Flat 5, okay, all right.
Yeah,
that's the A in that chord.
All right.
Is the flat five.
So you want to do it again, did you say?
Well, it would be nice because it was how do the part where you're going like, because I got the B going E7.
And then a sharp five, and then
sharp five,
E7, and then E7, flat five.
And then a, is that what the chord is?
Oh. There you go. I think that's it. Oh, there it is at the bottom of the right side of the screen.
It just sounds weird.
It's really all about that. It only goes up a half step. You don't go up to it's.
Oh, okay. I was going up to the fourth.
Six.
Just the third, okay. It's going to fix me.
I kind of pulled my ring finger back on that, so.
Yeah, but that guy was in
there with a version of the next one. Yeah. And it
was sharp.
Diminished, which sounds really good. As long as you can get it properly. I'll look this song up.
Okay, so.
Because it is a good one, but these chords are too complicated for me.
You gonna do it again?
When I saw the D sharp minor minus five, I said, oh well, goodbye.
Yeah, let's do it again. We just had to discuss some of these chords we're not used to. But we're ready now. We're gonna do this again.
Yeah.
So you want to do it again?
Yes.
Okay. I like this little intro that I'm just trying to practice.
Let the rain dry right on, let the wind
I'm sorry, I didn't realize, Walter, you were part of the performance, but from listening to it here, the synchronization is out so far, it was like...
Well, we weren't muted. I didn't realize.
Well, I unmuted it for Walter.
It was perfect. It was Zoom perfect.
It was perfect.
Yeah.
It was perfect on this end.
Yeah.
It was delayed enough where it almost got back in sync.
Okay.
But there's a program that I know is being tested. I think it's called InSync, and it's being developed by Diane Nalini's partner, who's a jazz musician. And I know there's a group in Canada that's been playing with it, which is synchronous playing where everyone can play together.
Oh, that's
probably worth checking out. One of the techie guys could check it out.
Nice.
Paul, tell us again.
InSync. Yeah, I'll send you the address, or I'll find it and send it to you. Who should I send it to, Paul?
Yeah, I guess so. I'll look into it. I know there was some software, a webpage kind of a thing that we looked at the beginning of the pandemic that had low latency play together as a group stuff, but you had to have special equipment for it to work well. Couldn't do it.
Yeah, you had to have a server for it, I think.
Yeah.
Who's next?
Who brought Stand By Me? That's a good one.
I did. I didn't know what, whether we, since we've already decided on the two songs we're going to play, that's fine. I was kind of brought it along because we had done it before. We can do it again.
Yeah, let's do it. I want to hear it again.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So.
That's a great song.
Walter, why don't you, I'll play the intro. You play the break in the middle.
Sure.
Okay.
Is it marked somewhere?
Yeah, it says instrumental break.
Yes, I can do that.
And it's just like, verse. I mean, the chord pattern never changes really. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we're ready. So let's start. It's 1, 2, 3.
Tumble and fall over the mountain. Ship
I thought that was curious. Because I hadn't finished playing the instrumental break, and you guys were already singing Darling, Darling.
Well, I lost count. I just started singing because Gary did, so I don't have any.
Yeah. You know, I think this is one of those songs that needs the breaks noted, because not everybody is breaking at the same time.
What happens is the singing comes back in before the last chord. In other words, you've got on the instrumental part, you've got one line where it's got two C's at the end, and then on the next part, it's got one C. The next C, the instrumental is still playing, and they, you know, Benny King comes back in with Darling, Darling, you know. So that's...
I know, but that's not the only place. Like, everywhere there are breaks, right? And it's not in unison because we're all thinking differently.
Well, yeah, that Paulette straightened me up.
Pretty well in unison. I didn't think there was anything wrong.
Yeah, it's the part that goes like, you know, darling, darling, stand by me. The G and the C, the standby, I mean, starts after the chord.
Well, if we were really going to do it for performance, we might want to be getting into this level of detail, but we're not going to do it.
Yeah.
You need one of those famous Bob commas.
Yeah, well, exactly. And we got, you know, we were practicing for that last time. That was last August, right?
Yeah, maybe August before that.
Two years ago?
Might be. I'm not sure. In any case, this is a pretty playable song. Maybe we ought to keep it as an option and decide later for sure what we're going to play.
Okay.
The intro sounded great, and so did the kazoo.
Yeah.
I like the song. Maybe we should sing it again.
Yeah, sounds good.
I think we still have.
Carol, if we do an open mic, you got to come down for it.
Send me a ticket, I'll be there. That would be fun.
Yeah.
Brenda, you have a song?
Brenda.
Yeah. I was supposed to do Scarborough Fair last week until I had to drop out to visit with the grandkids.
Well, I can pull that up.
In there somewhere.
I don't know why I have two of them here.
Yeah, that seems to be the one, I think. Okay. Yeah, let's just play it and see what happens.
Are you going to the Scarborough Fair? Don't you say trust? Thank you.
that's the end of that. That was great. Yeah. I love how it sounds like a really old song, but it's not.
Well, it is actually an old song.
Is it?
I think. I'm pretty sure it's... I don't know. Maybe I'm confusing it with Green Slaves, but...
No, I think you're right. I think it's an old traditional English song, but Simon and Garfunkel did it, and so some people might think they wrote it from scratch or something.
That's what I was about to ask. Is that the case? All right, cool.
Is the tune old and they wrote new words? Is that what it is?
They did it as an anti-war anthem, actually, because they had like a counterpoint verse about polishing of guns and stuff like that. You'll have to listen to it on one of their old albums. It was basically an anti-war song. The way they did it, they did it this way, and then they did it the other way too.
Yeah, they have a harpsichord in there.
Well, that would make it sound old.
Yeah. All right. So where are we?
Are we done now, or are we still doing stuff?
I think we've got a little more time left. I was just gonna play a song. I didn't send in any music because I got distracted with other stuff this week, so I didn't find a song and learn a song. So I'm gonna try to play a song that I used to know. I've practiced it a couple of times.
Times we're missing, spending the hours running.
wait, I said to myself, when we're old, we'll go dancing in the dark, walking through the park and reminiscing. We'll go dancing in the dark, walking through the park and reminiscing.
Gorgeous.
Oh, fantastic.
Man, what happened? That was actually good.
Oh, man.
So good. Wow.
So the song that I talked about, it's called Scarborough Pharaoh / Canticle. And it's on Parsley, Sage, Rosemary, and Thyme album. And it's got those lyrics about, you know, polishing guns and scarlet battalions and all that stuff. So, and it's on YouTube. Cool. If you're interested at all. Okay.
Well, what song was that? I didn't know that song.
That's Reminiscing by a Little River Band.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Mary Jane, you usually have a second song, do you tonight?
I do. If we have time to.
Sure, we got time.
Very jazzy.
Oh, the lovely chords! Wow.
That's the arrangement I got from Dr. Youp. So if you want to go looking for it, dryoup.com.
Thanks, Paul.
Sure.
So can you see the music?
Yeah.
Okay, I can't tell sometimes whether you guys are seeing it or not.
But it's not Mary Jane's song, but maybe she can wing it.
Are you having trouble? I have my song sheet here, if you can't find it.
What is the song?
It's called The Angel from Montgomery.
Oh, okay.
And that's one apparently we were thinking about doing, that I had a copy of it in my collection of songs that we were going to practice at Oscar Blue. There was all kinds of them. It was a great collection.
Yeah, we had a whole book.
I printed them all out, and I've been bringing them up here because there's so many good ones in there. But this was one of them, another John Prine song.
Yeah.
And just as depressing, if not more so, than the other song.
Well, that's the only reason I would veto this one for Kick Butt Coffee, because I like upbeat songs for Kick Butt Coffee.
Yeah, I was not making any suggestion that it be anything like that. I've been putting off doing it for a long time, but I thought maybe it was about time, since I was doing the other one that was real depressing. they make a nice pair. And I am an old woman too. When I first learned this song, I don't think I even had any gray hair.
Wow.
I am an old woman named after my mother. My old man is another child. Lightning and thunder were desire. This old house.
feel nice.
Right. Interesting song. Great song.
That's kind of unusual chord progressions in that song to me.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite John Prine songs, actually.
Okay, basically it's in D, but there's a C drum in there, so.
Yeah, C is unusual in the key of D.
Everybody. See you next time.
All right. Thanks for coming, Errol. See you later.
Yeah, good night, everybody.
Here for you. Thank you, everybody.
Okay, thanks, Gary. Thanks. Bye.
See y'all next week.
Yes.